Warning, this video contains spoilers that reveal critical parts of the game's storyline. If you don't want to see these, stop watching now. Hello again, my friends. Eric Pearson here. Hope you're all doing well, and welcome back to my ongoing coverage of Game Dev Tycoon from Greenheart Games. In the first video, I launched my new video game business, Tangent Systems, which I admit was an XP for the old Origin Systems that was popular in the 1980s. We've produced a few games with varying levels of success, so we're going to see how far we can keep going before we run out of business. So let's get started. Now, before I go any further, I'd like to give a healthy thank you to a friend of mine in the United Kingdom named Charlotte. Charlotte tipped me off to something I hadn't noticed before. You notice the car sitting in our garage with the tarp over it? It looks like a DeLorean. And of course, that fits in with the whole 1980s theme, so maybe we really did travel back in time to get in on the early days of the video game industry. So once again, Charlotte, thank you very much. Okay, so got some news here. The recently released TES home console by Nintendo has proven to be a massive success. Sales numbers have exceeded expectations by far. And before I go any further, that is true. When the Nintendo Entertainment System landed in the United States, it was a big, big hit. I mean, it really pumped a lot of life into the industry in North America after it had gone dormant for a period of time. All right, so we need to either do some research or develop a new game because our previous one, Espionage, is now off the market. And the customer says, I love the games that come with the TES, and playing with the controller is so much more fun than on a keyboard. And you know what? They're not wrong. I have to say, my family had an Apple II when I was a teenager, and I vastly preferred games that used a joystick to the keyboard. A lot of that was just because of the way the Apple II C keyboard was laid out, just personal preference. Okay, let's take a look at our options here. We can do some research. We've done some topics, but, you know, we've got enough research points to develop a custom game engine. So that might be worth doing because it would enable us to make better games. So let's get on this. So I'm going to say start research. Of course, this will cost us some time and money, but we've got some money. Okay, new research available, game tutorials and mono sound. All right, we haven't created an engine yet, but we need to mind our money, because if I create an engine, it's going to cost 50, 30. It's going to cost most of our money, and that could put us in the red. I don't want to do that yet. All right, I better get going on making a new game. So, develop new game. Let's pick a topic. Okay, we've already done city and military. We've done racing. We've done spy. We haven't done sports. Okay, maybe we should do a sports game. So we're going to do sports. The genre, I think, should be action. And for platform, because of money considerations, we're going to stick with the PC. But we need a name for our sports game. Well, let's see. Let's take a page from past history. The company Epix was very into making games based on things like the Olympics, like Summer Games and Winter Games. They did a game called California Games. They had another called World Games. So, what can we do here? Well, California Games is already taken. How about a shout to my friend down in Florida? Let's have Florida Games. Yeah, that's it. All right, let's go. We'll do 2D graphics. Okay, engine's going to be important. Gameplay, definitely. Story, maybe not so much, so I'll dial that down. All right, let's keep going. Yeah, I remember on the Apple II, I had Winter Games and I had California Games. Those were fun. Okay, development stage 2. Dialogue is not as important, but level design is, and so is artificial intelligence. Alright, let's keep going. Alright, world design is okay where it is. Graphics and sound are maxed out. Let's go with that. And it says here, research complete. Yes, I already knew that. Industry report. Recent studies suggest that increasing variety of gaming devices also creates a market for more specialized games. Some platforms become more popular with younger gamers, while others cater for the more mature age groups. And that makes sense. Okay. As more and more developers enter the market, we expect developers to focus their games on specific age groups to really make an impact. And yeah, that makes sense. And in line with that, target audience is a new research topic. Okay. We've got decent numbers. Yeah, don't forget creating custom game engines. Yes, we just did the research on that. Maybe next game. If this one earns well enough. Okay, no bugs. Good numbers on design and technology. Okay, new record for both. Alright, so we're making some good progress here. Alright, let's get this to the stores. First reviews have come in. Ooh, high numbers. Ooh, that's a good one. Very good. Ooh, yeah, this is good. I think we may make some good money on this one. Nice. Played it for days. That's always a good sign. Yeah. Alright. Alright, let's close out. And let's generate a game report. Following the massive success of the TES console, there are now rumors circulated that Vena, another Japanese company, is planning to release a home gaming console on their own. Yeah, I think this is the stand-in for Sega. Because if memory serves, about a year after the NES came to the United States, Sega released a console of their own, locally called the Sega Master System. Okay, let's give our game report here. Sports and action is a great combination. Graphics seems to be very important for this type of game. Yep, that makes sense. And we made some good money. Surprise hit with players. The developer Tangent Systems is fairly new to the gaming industry, but we cannot wait for what they develop next. Well, that's encouraging. Alright, we've got money. It's probably a good time to work on a custom engine. Okay. Alright, custom engine. We have to give it a name. Well, as a thank you to my dear friend in the UK, congratulations. Our new gaming engine, Charlotte. With 2D graphics, a linear story, and a save game. That's a good place to start. Okay, this is going to take some time and cost us some money. Nothing we can do about that. But while this is chugging along, hold that thought. Here it is. Vena has confirmed recent rumors about a new gaming console and announced the Master V. The company claims that the Master V is technically superior to the massively successful TES by Nintendo and plans to release it in the coming months. And yeah, I played a friend's Sega Master System when I was a teenager, and it was a pretty good console for the time. Okay, so moving along here. One fond memory I have from that era is there used to be a bookstore chain called B. Dalton Booksellers, and for a time, the back of the store was all computer books and computer games and software, and they called that subsection Software, etc. And eventually, it expanded into its own separate chain of stores, And in time, they moved, the local one moved out of B. Dalton and had a location of its own in a different mall. And I was a regular there, if not to buy, then at least to look around. Okay, so Charlotte is now complete. So now that that's done, we need to pick a new game. Alright, let's look at our game history. Florida Games was good, but it might be too soon to do a sequel. Espionage was a 5, City Manager was a 6.5, Psychomania was a 4, Tank Simulator, What are our potential topics? Are there any topics I haven't done yet? Let's look. Well, we haven't done fashion, but you know what? I'm just not feeling fashion. Maybe we need to take a moment and research a new topic. New topic. There's mad science, there's pirates, space, prison. Wow, you got a lot. That's the one thing, is every time I play this game, the topics that you start with and the topics that come up for potential research shuffle around. I don't even know the full balance of what they've got, but you know what? Maybe space is a good one to try next. So let's try that. So I'm going to research space. And then once that's done, we'll start developing a new game and see how well it does. And meanwhile, we've got 327 fans. We're in year 3, month 6, week 1. Alright. Alright, time to develop a game. Alright, develop new game. Alright. There was a game for the Commodore 64 that I used to play at a friend's house. And it was called Iridium, or it was spelled with a U, Iridium. So, there is no actual Iridium, there's Iridium, which is an element on the periodic table. So, let's have a little fun. Instead of Iridium or Iridium, how about Tungsten? That's right. Stop the aliens from the hostile planet Tungsten. Alright. Topic. Space. Genre, we're going to make this action. Platform, we're going to do... See, now I'm going to share something else with you here. Let's take a look at this. This is the TES. Okay, they've got a good market share. But there's a license cost, $80,000. Okay. And this mirrors industry history. Remember what I said about Nintendo being very careful not to repeat the mistakes made leading up to the crash of 1983. Well, one of the things that they did is they wielded very tight control of who could produce software for the Nintendo Entertainment System and how often they could release games. They did not want the market flooded and lead to customer and retailer confusion. In fact, if memory serves, during the height of the NES era, no developer could release more than 5 games for the NES per year. And in fact, there was one developer, Konami, who was also famous for making arcade games. They had a cute little workaround for that. What they did is they created a sister company called Ultra Games. But it was basically the same people, more or less. So that enabled them to release 5 titles a year under the Konami label, and then 5 under the Ultra Games label. So there's a little bit of history. Okay, enough of that. Let's get cracking. Tungsten. And we're going to use our freshly minted Charlotte engine. Let's go. We're going to go to 2D graphics version 2. That will cost us more money, but we've got it. Alright. Let's go through these. Alright, engine is good. Gameplay, story, not so much. We want linear story and a save game feature. Based on history, probably a password save. Because that's how a lot of games did it at the time. Alright, The new Master V from Vena has been released, alright? I think the first game of this era that had an actual battery backup might have been the second Legend of Zelda game. Or maybe the first, one of the two. Alright, so dialogue not so important. Level design very important. Artificial intelligence very important. Alright. Alright, we got 2D graphics, basic sound. World design, I can bump that up a little bit. Maybe up to half. Graphics and sound are pegged. Okay, let's keep it going. The recently released gaming console Master V by Vena has stirred up the market worldwide. Industry experts say the console is not very well marketed in North America, but that it will flourish in other parts of the world. And that is true. It lasted a lot longer in other parts of the world than it did in the United States. Sorry to say that. First time around, Nintendo reigned supreme with the console wars then. Alright. Pretty good numbers, but we gotta resolve some bugs. Okay. Okay, that's good enough. Some decent upgrades on the experience. Let's put this out and see what happens. Alright, what do we got? 7, that's good. That's very good. 9, nice, nice. 7, that's good. That's good. And an 8, that's good. Nice. Alright. Alright, let's get a game report going. Got a lot of research points. Man, we're making some good money, too. Okay, that report should be due in. Here we go. Post-release analysis. Level design is quite important for this type of game. Alright. And that's it. The latest game has been received very positive reviews overall. Informed Gamer gave it a 9, saying almost perfect. If Tangent Systems continues to innovate like this, they might become a new fan favorite. Well, that's very flattering news. Thank you very much for that. Alright. Alright, let's see what research we can do. Alright. We should probably push the limits of our technology. Let's try some mono sound. Let's push that a little bit. It's going to cost us some money, but worth doing. Because let's face it, sound design is important to a game. I remember the chills I felt the first time I saw Ghostbusters for the Commodore 64 and the game actually talked. When it first loaded up, you heard, "Ghostbusters!" And then the blood-curdling scream the game let out when you finally closed the portal to the spirit world. I tell you what, that gave me chills. Not lying. Okay, new research available in casual games. That's good. Alright, what other research can we do? We already did. Alright. We should probably do target audience. Because let's face it, marketing is important whether anyone wants to admit it or not. Uh-oh. Recent market data shows that the Commodore 64 seems to be losing market share against other PC manufacturers. And yeah, that did happen. The Commodore 64 for a time was a great machine, but it started to lose steam over time. The other thing is, while it was great at playing games, and it was a good affordable machine, but loading programs on it took a very long time. I mean, the joke that I tell people about old computers from the past was that when you want to load up a game on a Commodore, it was load *8,1, hit enter, and go make a sandwich. Because it would take time for the program to slowly load itself into memory. And at one point, the game developer Epix, famous for Summer Games, Winter Games, etc., they made a lot of money selling something called a fast load cartridge, which fit into the Commodore 64's cartridge slot, and it would boost load speeds for Commodore games by a factor of 5. And I remember the difference because I had one extended family member who had a Commodore but didn't have fast load, and then I had a friend of mine in high school who had a Commodore 64 and did. And let me tell you, night and day difference. Alright, so we've done some research here, and it also says something else here. In an unofficial statement, a G64 employee said that the company has been unsuccessful in introducing higher-priced computers to compete against newer and more advanced PCs. And sad to say, yeah, that sort of happened as well. Commodore did, in the real world, develop the Amiga line of computers, and I have to say, they were very high-quality machines. They played great games, and they were also very powerful tools for people who did creative work. I've known cartoonists who got their chops doing computer art and animation on the Amiga, and these folks were keeping their old Amigas going through the 90s and I think maybe even into the early 2000s, no joke. So, all right. I'm going to stop here. I think this is a good place to stop. So we are making progress. We're making good money. We're getting some good press, building our fans. So thank you very much for watching, and join me next time as I continue playing Game Dev Tycoon. Eric Pearson, signing off.